Today class we will discuss about competitive examination, its adverse effect on learner, education system and society. Here in this discussion we will see what is the competitive examination, okay, and what are the possible adverse effect, negative effect, undesirable effect on the part of education system, on the part of a learner, on the part of a society. So this thing we will be discussing in this class. When we talk about the competitive examination is a kind of testing wherein we try to estimate the knowledge, skill, understanding of the person to place them suitably. So competitive examination is a kind of a test, examination procedures, wherein we are trying to estimate the knowledge, understanding, skill, capacity, strength to place them in a suitable position. To place them in a suitable position means that based upon the performance of a person, they will be either admitted to a course. If it is the competitive examination is for admitting in some course, or to employ the person. If the competitive examination is designed for giving them employment opportunity, so competitive examination is that a procedure. This is that. So here we try to estimate what is the knowledge of the person is. So the person who is more knowledgeable to them, we will give admission in some course, or we will recruit for some job. The person who is more skilled, so we will give them employment opportunity, or we will admit in some course, like that. So it is a process to estimate and place them suitably to assess and take a person for suitable type of a work. Then the point comes that why this competitive examination is required. If we are doing a competitive examination, then also there is a very obvious kind of a question: why these competitive examinations are existing? So there are variety of reason of conducting competitive examinations. The one very obvious reason is that the population. If the population is so high, so big, and the number of a seat available is less, then obviously we have to choose a required number of a candidate out of the whole population. For sake of example, you can understand that in the B.Ed, the department in which we are running the B.Ed program, our university department, we have only 50 seats. So, and the total number of applicant is about 3,000. So out of the 3,000, we have to pick 50 only. So we will try to see that out of those 3,000, who are more suitable for the course in terms of their attitude, aptitude, knowledge and understanding of the different concept of the domain. So this is the one of the very obvious reason If the population is very big and the number of available seats are very less, like that for the job also you can say. For sake of example, 100 seats are there, 100 seats are vacant, vacancy is 100, and the number of applicant is 1 lakh. 1 lakh is a number of applicant. So out of the 1 lakh applicant, we have to select only 100. We have to select only 100. So what we will do? Out of the 1 lakh, we will try to select suitable candidate who are more suitable for the post. I'm not saying that the others who are not selected for the employment or who are not selected for the enrollment in any particular course, they are not at all eligible. No, they may be eligible or may not be depending upon the situation. But here the fact is, out of the eligible candidate who are more suitable. Maybe like that, suppose that for sake of example, in a competency and scale, suppose that I am thinking that those who are securing minimum 50 mark, they can be given employment opportunity. Minimum 50 mark, those who are securing, they can be employed. And out of 1 lakh applicant, there are 10,000 applicant who have secured more than 50 marks. So they all are eligible, they all are suitable. But when we talk about the competitive examination, here we are talking that who are more suitable. So we will again see, we will make a list of eligible candidate wherein those who have secured 50 and more, they will be coming there in that list, isn't it? But within that, we will see that in the decreasing, in the list of a candidate with a decreasing mark, so who are at the top of the list? And those who are at the top of the list, they will get the opportunity for employment. So this is the one thing when we talk about the competitive examination. Another thing is that to know the suitability of the candidate. Here I am not interested that those who will secure more mark and they will be selected for the employment and the enrollment opportunity. No, here I am trying to see the suitability, whether the applicant, whether the candidate have a required competency for the employment or for the course. If it is for the employment job, then competency for the job, or otherwise if it is for the course, then required level of a competency for the course. So here we are trying to see the required level of competency, and in this case it may be possible that if the 10,000 is an applicant and none of them or some of them may not have the required level of a competency, like that the 1,000 applicant is there and 100 seats are there, but out of the 1,000 only 50 students have a required level of a competency. So only 50 seat will be filled, other seat may be left unfilled because the rest of the applicant do not have a required level of a competency. So required level of competency is not there, and these things are used especially in the medical profession, in the law, in the engineering, even architect, that you have to secure minimum percentage of mark in order to be eligible to get a job or to get a opportunity for enrollment. Like that, there is a 1000 applicant and the seat is 100, and the required level of a competency in terms of a mark is suppose that a 50 mark. But only 20 students have secured more than 50. So only those 20 will get employment opportunity if it is for a job, or the enrollment opportunity if it is for a admission into some course. So that is the one necessity of having a competitive examination. Okay, but we see that these competitive examinations are designed for a betterment of a profession, so that a quality person may come into the profession, person with quality. So it looks like that, okay, so it's very good, bahut acha hai, everything is well and fine, and it is designed for a betterment of the profession and for the betterment of the everything. But there are some negative effect too. Because why the negative effect is that here you have a pressure to come in the top position. You have a pressure to perform best, not better, best. Why? Because in a regular examination, like academic examination that we used to have, there we know that there is a cutoff. Like that, if you are securing 60 or more percentage of a mark, then you will get a first division. If you are securing 55 or 45, then you will pass, like that. So passing, criteria of passing is clearly defined, that if you are securing 60 and 60 plus percentage of mark, you will get a first division of a mark. So there is no problem. So I'm not saying that here the anxiety and stress is not coming, but the kind of stress and anxiety is less. But when we think about the competitive examination, there the cutoff mark is not clear. The cutoff mark will be decided based upon the performance of a candidate in the exam. For sake of example, again think that the 1000 candidates are there and 100 seat is there. So if the performance of every candidate is low, so the cutoff mark will go low. For sake of example, it is a 80. But if the performance of a candidate in that examination is very good, very high, then the cutoff mark will also increase. It may be 90-95. So here you don't know that how much percentage of a mark you are supposed to secure in order to qualify. It is a totally uncertain, unless or until the mark secured by each and every candidate is calculated and tabulated. Then only you will be able to know that what is your position and what is the probability of your selection for that job or in some courses. Probability of selection. Probability, when we say that, means that it is uncertain. There is no certainty. So this is the unique feature of competitive examination. Here you don't know, and that's why you try to fetch more and more mark in the competitive examination in order to assure your selection. If you want that your selection should be there, you want to assure your selection, then you have to secure more and more mark, and you will work for that. And so in order to secure more and more mark, what will be there? The one thing is that you will start thinking that will increase your anxiety and stress level. That will increase. So it is found that the people, the candidate who are preparing for a competitive examination, they are in the high stress and the level of anxiety in them is very high. It is established in the several researches also. And forget about the research. You just think about you, that when you were preparing for some examinations. So I was saying, just remember your time, that when you were preparing for examination, so what was the level of stress and anxiety? Okay. So you can easily understand that how much stress and anxiety this competitive examination used to put on the candidate. And the second thing is that when we talk about the increased level of stress and increased level of anxiety, then it decreases your health. So it will start creating the health problems, because it is increasing the level of stress and the level of anxiety. So it will start increasing your health problem too. This is the one common logic and connection. The second thing is that due to this competitive examination, and more about, you can say that due to the nature of competitive examination, because the nature is that you don't know that what is the cutoff mark. It is uncertain. You are forced to fetch more and more mark, isn't it? So in order to fetch more and more mark, we try to focus our mind on the study. So we limit the other essential activity of our life. What are the other essential activity? Like that, the talking with our friends, mingling with the society members, talking with your family, going to market, because when we go outside, it refreshes our mind. So we are limiting these things. And when we will stop talking to the friends, stop talking with the family member, then again it will increase the stress and anxiety. So it will create a circular type of a problem. It is increasing stress and anxiety, and we are limiting ourselves to talk with our friends and a family member, and then it is again increasing the stress and anxiety. So it will create a serious health problem. We also try to limit our sleep, like that ideally we must sleep 8 hours per day, per 24 hour, 8 hour minimum sleep. It is a variable. Sometimes it is required more also if you are sick, or it varies from the age point of view also. But on an average, we know that it is 8 hours of a sleep is required. Peaceful sleep. So we cut the sleeping time also. So again, it will give an adverse effect on the health. We limit our physical exercise also. Like that, I am sitting here and I am reading. I will just go for some food, and food I will also take in a hurry. It will be not properly chewed, so there will be a digestion problem. You are limiting a physical exercise, so it will again create a digestion problem, and other related health issues will come. So competitive examination is found that one of the major reason for stress and anxiety and a health problem in the adolescent, in the among the children, among the students. So health problem is also a big problem put by the competitive examination. However, in the competitive examination, we are trying to select a suitable person, and if the person is a suitable, then we can know that they will work better for the betterment, isn't it? But it is also putting some serious issue. It also gives, or it also promotes the tendency of rote learning. Here, if something we are not getting it, that how it is happening, we are not understanding conceptual part of the thing, then we try to memorize by heart. That is a rote learning. We try to memorize by heart. Whatever is that, you remember and write in an examination, get the mark and get selection. So the tendency of rote learning is also found to be increased when the competitive examination comes. Even the when we talk about the learner have been found that when they are preparing for competitive examination, and the context where they don't know what will be the cutoff mark, what will be their selection, because selection is also uncertain. If the cutoff mark is uncertain, then the selection is uncertain. So they are uncertain about that. The stress and anxiety is increasing. The health problem is also coming in between. So in this context, due to the nature of competitive examination, students try to get more and more mark, and they are also uncertain about what is the cutoff mark. Okay, so in this context, their stress and anxiety increases, their health decreases, and the tendency of rote learning increases, which creates a situation of low level of a confidence on them, which creates a situation that promotes the lack of confidence on themselves, on their self. The student, they don't have a confidence that what will be their future, whether they will be able to get through or not. So this type of a situation comes. Even when we talk that the tendency of rote learning increases, so obviously the creativity, critical thinking, these things will also come, and these things will decrease. So creativity, critical thinking, problem solving ability, which are the essential component of a learning process, and it is the essential for the betterment of the future of the learner, they are lost. The student start having a inferiority complex. They suffer from the inferiority complex. They have a problem of a fear, and sometimes it is also found, very frequently it is found that the student who are not getting success after the repeated attempt, they are committing suicide. So it is a increasing, triggering the tendency of suicide. It has been found. The student who have not got the success, suppose that they are preparing for engineering examination, medical examination, and after the repeated exam attempts, 4, 5, 6 time attempt, they are not getting, and they used to commit a suicide. So this is the problem that comes when we talk about the competitive examination and its bad effect, adverse effect on the part of a learner. Even it have the adverse effect in the education system also. Because when we talk about the education system is designed in a such a way to achieve the learning outcome as per the concept, context and a content in a grade appropriate manner. But due to the competitive examination, 2-3 things comes. One thing is that a student try to solve a problem, try to go through the concepts which is of a higher standard level in an early age. Like that, when you will see the engineering, the student used to prepare for medical and IIT examination right from the class 9th, which not only giving them extra anxiety pressure, but also it is harming the education system by promoting a rote learning, by not achieving the learning outcome, by promoting the not promoting the creativity, critical thinking and a problem solving. Because it is supposed that when the student will come out of the education system, school education, they will have this kind of a competency to lead their life. But in the name of competitive examination, by focusing their mind in the competitive examination, they have not focused much and they don't have a required level of a competency. Rote learning is being promoted. That is a very serious concern about the competitive examination. And more clearly, when you will see the National Education Policy 2020, which says that the culture of a coaching is a serious concern in the country and that should be deprioritized. It creates a culture of coaching. Even when you will go the quota, you must be knowing the Rajasthan quota, which is known as the IIT factory, quota factory. Students don't go to the school. They are enrolled in some XYZ school. They are not going in the school and they are in the coaching centers. Coaching center are catering, developing their mind one-sidedly. That is not the holistic development. But for to live the life, the holistic development is required. One example I will see, a quote from my real life also. I will not take the name of schools and all those things, but there is a very famous school. Okay. So, I had one friend during my plus two times. And his father was a teacher in that famous school. So that famous school means their student used to come in the top 10 always by default that they will be from the top 10. So I told that that school is a very good school like that. Then what he replied that yes, for the rest of the country, it is a one of the best school. But we know that what we are doing there, you will find several selection in the IIT, AIIMS, and in the top position of all the jobs in the country from our school. Yes, it's right. But we know that what we are preparing them. He told that you can find our candidate in IITs, AIIMS, but you will never find that our student has been rewarded for a good work. So that is the one side development of a mind. We know that the students are there, my students are there, but you will never find my student that they have been rewarded for a good work. So that is the problem with a coaching culture, because nowadays some schools are also running like a coaching centers, and they have tied up with the some coaching centers. So their enrollment in the some school and they will be in the coaching center. So that is the serious side effect, bad effect on the schooling system, even for the parent and the society. It also creates a stress and an anxiety for them. I have seen that parents are taking 1 and 2 months of a leave from their job to make them prepare their child for board examination. They used to take leave from their job because it is also a matter of stress and anxiety, because they used to judge their parenting with the success of a child in a particular field. But that is not a correct. If the child is not able to be an engineer, there then is no question that your parenting was wrong. No, it is the interest of a child, and we know that every child is a unique. It is a uniqueness of a child. So unnecessary competition and anxiety, health issue, all those things comes on the part of a society and a parents also. So in total, when we see this competitive examination and the nature of a competitive examination unnecessarily creates a lot of a problem which is not desirable for the education system today.